As we described in BRL, condition variables are synchronization constructs which allow block threads to be notified once a specific condition occurs. BRL proposed the condition as condition variable abstraction, as well as three operations, wait, signal, and broadcast, that can be performed on condition variables. In Pthread's, condition variables are represented via the designated condition variable data type. The remaining operations align really well with BRL's mechanisms. For instance, for wait, Pthread has a Pthread condition wait that takes two arguments, a condition variable and a mutex, just like what we saw in BRL's wait. The semantics of this operation is also identical to BRL's wait. A thread that's entering the wait operation, a thread that must wait, will automatically release the mutex and place itself on the wait queue that's associated with the condition variable. When the thread is woken up, it will automatically reacquire the mutex before actually exiting the wait operation. This is identical to the behavior we saw in BRL's wait. Identical to the signal and broadcast mechanisms in BRL, Pthread has Pthread condition signal and Pthread condition broadcast that we can use to either notify one thread that's waiting on a condition variable using the signal operation, or to notify all threads that are waiting on a condition variable using the Pthread condition broadcast operation. There are also some other common operations that are used in conjunction with condition variables. These include the init and destroy functions. Pthread condition init is pretty straightforward. You have to use this operation in order to allocate the data structure for the condition and in order to initialize its attributes. Like what we saw with mutexes, the attributes can further specify the behavior that Pthread provides with conditions. For instance, an example is whether or not the condition variable will be used only within threads that belong to a single process or also shared across processes. And similar to what we saw with the mutex and threads attributes data structures, passing null in this call will result in the default behavior that's supported by pthreads. That happens to be that the condition variable is private to a process. Just like threads, condition variables should be explicitly freed and deallocated. We use the condition destroy call for that. And finally, a few pieces of advice regarding the use of condition variables. First, make sure you don't forget to notify the waiting threads. Whenever any aspect of a predicate that some threads are waiting on change, make sure that you signal or broadcast the correct condition variables that these threads are waiting on. Next, if you're ever in doubt whether you should use signal or broadcast, use broadcast until you figure out what the desired behavior is. Note that with broadcast, you will lose performance, so make sure you use the correct notification mechanism, signal or broadcast, when you need to wake up threads from a condition variable. Remember, since you don't actually need a mutex to signal and broadcast, it may be appropriate for you to remove that signal and broadcast operation until after you've unlocked the mutex, just like what we saw in the introductory lecture about threads. We will point out some of these options during the discussion of an actual Pthreads example that we'll do next.